Welcome to Baja Mexico Vespa Day 3, the third and final day of this fantastic Vespa experience through the Baja Peninsula. We woke up in San Felipe on day 3 to a beautiful sunrise. We've had two distinctly different days. Day 1, we rode from La Jolla down to San Quentin, stopping off in Ensenada for some world-famous tostadas and fish tacos. On day 2 was completely different. We rode across the desert and the mountains, traversing the Baja Peninsula from the Pacific Ocean all the way out to the Gulf of Mexico. Day 3 is our third and final day, where we're taking off from San Felipe and heading all the way back to La Jolla, crossing the U.S. border in Mexicali. It should take about 6 hours and 450 kilometers, but you know it's going to take a lot longer than 6 hours. This is my ritual every single morning. I load the bag up, make sure that it's safely secured, make sure I've got my spare tank of gas, check my oil, check my air pressure, make sure I've got everything, and getting ready to go.
Coldest one.
Gonna get warmer with time, I hope. It did not get warmer with time. In fact, it got colder and colder. I was sure glad I packed double gloves with me and I have brought my thermos along. The arches are a local landmark and they signify the entry into San Felipe. But in our case, the exit, all the way up to Mexicali. The ride on day 3 did not disappoint. Beauty all around us. I'm looking at these mountains and I can't believe the day before we crossed those mountains to make it all the way across to the other side of Baja. And of course, I've got one eye on a gas gauge, thinking there should be a gas station between San Felipe and Mexicali, right? Right? There should be. As I'm looking out onto the horizon, I don't see any sign of life anywhere near. Look at those mountains. What I learned about riding through Mexico is that there are multiple military checkpoints along the way. So this is another military checkpoint. There's a few of those. This guy's getting questioned.
We'll see what they ask.
I wonder what they're looking for. They didn't even stop us for a chat. They just waved us along the way. I guess we know who they were looking for or what they were looking for. Any which way, next stop, Mexicali. And a gas station, hopefully, before then. Mile after mile, we were treated to some gorgeous views in Mexico. 3 days of just stunning scenery. At this point, my gas gauge is blinking and I pull over for a little break and have a chat with my brother, only for him to tell me that he forgot his tank of gas back in San Felipe, and no way do we have enough to go all the way back there and get it. So from here on in, we're gonna have to ride a little bit more conservatively. Just check out these views. Absolutely glorious. We were a little encouraged when we saw some signs of civilization. Still no gas station though. It was just a matter of time before we get to see one. I hope. As was the case in magical Mexico, out of nowhere, a gas station popped up and saved our bacon. I should have more faith in Mexico.
Frazzles! Frazzles! How desperate was your situation? That was desperate, dude.
Holy shit. Mine was sputtering.
You were cruising there at the end.
I was more worried about you.
God damn.
You've got to worry if you've got enough cash to pay for this.
Oh, I've got enough cash.
There's no cards. No, I've got cash.
So this is our last stop before we cross the border. Way, oh, say, can you see? The one thing you ought to be careful of when you're taking these long rides is you have to be aware of complacency. Just because we're near the border, it does not mean that our journey is anywhere close to being over, as we found out. We still got a long way to go. And now we're rolling through this concrete jungle called Mexicali on the US-Mexico border. It certainly is a culture shock. We just spent 3 days riding through some beautiful coastal towns, over mountains, seeing some beautiful beaches, some incredible scenery, only to be met by this concrete jungle on the US-Mexico border. We're getting closer and closer to crossing the border. Oh, say, can you see? This is not a simple case of just riding up to the border and crossing it. Google Maps took us on the spaghetti loops around and around these different neighborhoods just so we could get to the border, and we were greeted by the wall. Check this wall out. I was following my brother to the border. I knew this was too good to be true. We've got this empty free lane all to ourselves, while on the right, there is a gigantic long traffic jam to cross the border. But hey, here we are. We got this whole road to ourselves, unimpeded. Too good to be true. Just look at this traffic. It would have taken hours if we were driving by car. I can't imagine how it feels to be sitting in that forever and a day. And here we are, just waltzing through on our own private lane. So Frazzles, they pulled us over, a couple of Iraqi-looking fellas.
Oh, what can I say?
Crossing into Mexico.
Crossing
no, into the U.S.,
the
yeah.
States.
Yeah.
They're like, why is your vehicle from North Carolina? I'm like, because it is. And
oh, that's what happened. You fucked it up for the both of us.
Fuck off!
It does say North Carolina.
I did. I said the guy behind me is carrying all, he's my mule.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Come on. It's that point. No, we're supposed to register our vehicles with our global entry. I'm carrying, hold on here. Let me show you. I'm carrying it. Legit. There it is. Global entry. Thank you.
Half an hour later, they let us go and we were on our way. I still would rather be apprehended for half an hour than having to sit in that traffic forever.
Welcome to America. Oh, I'll follow you.
As soon as we crossed into America, we took a sharp left heading west on California Route 98. We're now running parallel to the US-Mexico border. and over here to my left is Mexico. Now, along the way, we kept seeing a ton of Customs and Border Patrol trucks. They were everywhere. They were working double time. Like right here, out of nowhere, this truck just pops up and it just heads right into the desert, kicking up a storm behind it. Speaking of a storm, there was a black cloud here that was looking ominous. We started to feel some raindrops, so my brother pulled over and got his waterproofs on.
I think we could outrun this.
Oh yeah. Well, I've been through a storm, I'm not going through one again.
Oh, the wind is picking up.
Can you see it over there? Can't see shit.
Yeah.
We had no choice but to gun it and seek shelter.
Well, there's never a dull moment on this trip. Now it's raining. Brussels, are we going for it?
Let's gun it.
All right.
Yeah. I mean, it's windy.
Yeah.
It's raining.
Yeah.
But it's, I'm going to put the phone away because it's just eight. Wait until you hit five.
Yeah. Alright, so no more videos from now till we get out of this place. Golly.
Probably gonna regret this decision, but okay.
No, let's do it. Let's go.
We hopped off the back road of California Highway 98 and jumped on Interstate 8. This way, if there was bad weather, at least there'll be plenty of places to shelter and gas stations to hide out in. Seeing all these wind turbines reminded me of Oklahoma. On my coast-to-coast cannonball ride, day 5, go check it out on my YouTube channel. Oklahoma was super windy, and there was a ton of wind farms. It makes total sense to have them up here too. It was windy. If I was amazed on day 2 in Mexico looking at the mountain made of boulders, then this here are mountain ranges made of boulders. Check this out. These are boulders that make up mountains that go on forever. This is absolutely mind-blowing on Route 8 in California. Absolutely astonishing. It got cold, windy, and wet real fast. At this point, it was getting too dangerous to ride, so we had to pull over.
The hits keep on coming.
Holy shit. That was tough.
There's always an adventure at every turn. Have you heard the expression El Chilim Khabal Al Taras Halge?
El Chilim Khabal Al Taras Halge?
Yeah.
That's what I do.
It's just, you know, like when a crazy man wants to chew bubble gum, he puts the whole thing in his mouth.
That's what I do.
El Chilim Khabal Al Taras Halge, crazy bubble gum. I mean, we did it all. We did El Chilim Khabal Al Taras Halge. We did it all. And honestly, and this trip gave us everything. For fuck's sake. This trip has got to have it all, otherwise it just wouldn't be a trip.
Well, tell you what we could do with that. It's like a puncher or something.
All right, are you ready? For fuck's sake, what happened? It was a beautiful day.
It's a gorgeous day. Fucking cold is what happened, like snow cold.
God damn, it's freezing.
I
keep telling you, I mean, it is a new year. It is winter. All right, are you ready? 5 more minutes. Let's get that beef jerky out.
We had to get going in this rain and this windstorm. There was no way about it. We had to keep on going. Now, I pulled over frequently, but my brother just kept going. He didn't care. He just gunned it all the way back home. For me, I wanted to get there in one piece.
I had to pull over. That was treacherous. I had to pull over. on the highway. So Forrest kept on going, and I fancied a burger as well. And there's a gas station right here across the street. I'd rather get there in one piece than not get there at all. But look at it, it's absolutely foul. It's raining. It's just on the highway. That was just some dangerous stuff. But so I decided to pull over and just take it easy and maybe get myself a burger. See what's happening over there at the, pizza. All right, there's never a dull moment.
I waited a while and I waited for the clouds to break and the sun to come out and just take it very easy on a wet surface, making my way back to La Jolla. I can feel it. I'm getting closer. The skies are blue. The sun is shining. What a fantastic ride. What an incredible day.
And that is that.
Thank you so much for coming along with us on this epic 3-day journey through Baja. Please smash a like, leave a comment, and subscribe to my YouTube channel called Away We Go!